Robert Cray knows guitars like the back of his hand. His distinctive blues sound has led to collaborations with legends like B.B. King, Tina Turner and Eric Clapton.
Robert has received 5 Grammy Awards and his new album, which is called Cooking in Mobile, which is in Alabama, is out later this month. Robert's here. Morning.
Morning.
Nice to see you.
Thank you very much.
First, we're going to have a little listen to your album. Here
okay.
it is.
Get a constant busy signal when I call you on the phone. Get a strong uneasy feeling you're not sitting there alone. Have a nasty, nasty vision, baby. Shoot as a sweat begins to dry and you begin to forget why you came. You can't even look me in the eye. You can come by late at night, anytime. Anytime.
Yeah, well, sit down, Brandy.
We're just talking to Robert about that. That's the DVD that accompanies the
CD,
isn't it?
Yes, right.
Cooking in Mobile. So it was all done live?
It's all done live.
Wow.
Yeah.
The audience were very quiet and respectful, weren't they?
The audience were quiet, but yet it's a sit-down theater, so, you know, they respond after the songs are over.
Why did you choose Mobile? Because any other musical reference I remember from Mobile is Bob Dylan to be stuck inside Memphis with the Mobile with the Memphis Blues again.
I don't know about the Bob Dylan thing, but we did it because it's a nice venue, the Sanger Theater in Mobile, Alabama. It's an old classic. Part of the theater is on the front cover, and it's just a really nice old venue. Mm.
When did you first pick up a musical instrument and think, this is what I want to do?
Well, I picked up the guitar when I was 12 years old, and it was because of the Beatles.
Oh, was it?
I wanted to be like George Harrison.
Really?
And that was in the mid-60s. And but when I got a guitar, I just kept playing. I never really quit. So.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And your favorite guitars are?
Fender Stratocaster.
Why do you get a different sound from that than other? I mean, just to a novice who knows nothing about guitars, why is that the key guitar to play on?
Well, it's what I like. I like it because it's just a basic workhorse of a guitar, no frills. And there's a lot of people that play the Stratocaster, obviously, but it all depends on the way you handle it, how you touch it, that gives you your own distinct
because there's a fundamental divide, isn't there, in the electric guitar world? I'm speaking as a complete novice here. You've got the Stratocaster, the Fender, and is it the Gibson or is it Les Paul?
Gibson is the rivalry, yeah.
Oh, we're getting very technical now. We're talking about various.
Hendrix had a
Stratocaster,
didn't he? And mm-hmm. he was a big influence on you?
Hendrix was, and actually I lived in Tacoma, Washington for the longest time, which is near Seattle. And I got to see Jimmy a couple times.
Did
yeah,
you?
I did. Yeah.
Before he moved.
After he came here. Yeah. Mm.
A lot of the reviews that I've read have said you've got a very distinctive style. That you tend to mix lots of different styles together.
Right.
You do. Do you think you have created something out of the ordinary?
Well, I think we've added to what is everybody's perception of what the band is. People like to say that we're a blues band, but we incorporate rock, we incorporate blues, a little gospel, a little bit of jazz, and that kind of thing into our music.
I don't know when you get into the country. How long ago?
Just a week.
Just a week. Okay. Mm-hmm. Just actually when catching our World Cup hangover.
Right.
Perhaps for your tour, you should. It might be people would appreciate if you wrote a song singing about the World Cup blues. As an American too, because
well, we went out before Britain did, so yeah. No, it's not that bad. It's only a game.
I woke up this morning and my side had lost again.
So what are you doing in the UK? How many do you do?
Well, we've been to. We started in Belfast. Yep. We went to Liverpool, Leicester, Norwich. and Brighton.
Wow, so you've done quite a full tour already.
We'll do London, we'll do Manchester, Cambridge.
Do British audiences react differently to your music from those elsewhere in the world, particularly America?
The reaction, I think, is attributed to a little bit more knowledge about our music here.
Really?
Than in the States.
And it started. We know more about blues here than they do in the States.
I think that people pay more attention to blues music here than they do possibly in the States, because I know that we were more successful here in Britain than we were in the States earlier on.
Oh, yeah. That's interesting. Mm-hmm. Well, you've obviously had a successful tour so far. You've enjoyed it. Very busy.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah.
So how much longer have you got? Another couple of weeks?
Until the 17th.
Okay, all right. Well, enjoy it. Thank you very much for
coming
in.
Thank you.
And thanks for paying us Brits the compliment of knowing more about the blues than the people
than
who
the Americans
read the blues.
Yeah, exactly.
Thanks a lot, Robin.
Thank you.